Next, we have to set up the costs. So regular time wages, we're going to calculate that based on the number of workers. So let's sum the number of workers. And we can copy that formula for hires and fires, because we will need to compute the hiring cost and firing cost with these two sums. Okay. And similarly here for overtime, we need to sum the overtime and copy that to subcontracting and copy that to the ending inventory. Now, regular time wages is number of worker months times wage rate per worker per month, which is here. So that will give us the wage to be paid. Overtime cost is the total overtime production in units times overtime rate per unit. That's your production rate, overtime cost per unit. So this will give us the total overtime cost. Next is subcontracting. Again, take the sum of the subcontracting multiplied by subcontracting cost per unit, which is given right there. Hiring cost is total workers hired multiplied by hiring cost. Okay, this is per worker, so hiring cost per worker. And then firing cost will be number of total workers fired times firing cost per worker. Now finally, carrying cost, so that is the sum of the ending inventories times carrying cost per unit per month. Now you sum that, that's your total cost. Now we need to run solver. So go to data and solver. Now the objective cell for us is the total cost, and that needs to be minimized. Now by changing cells, okay, we have hiring and firing, so that's one set, and then overtime and subcontracting, that is a second set. Then we add constraints. So the constraints are your ending inventories must be greater than or equal to safety stock. That's one set. And then the second set is overtime must be less than or equal to the limit for overtime. Now we want the number of hires and fires, the OT, overtime production, subcontracting production, to be integer. But let's first run the problem as is, and if the answers come out to be integer by itself, then that's it. You don't need to add those constraints. There are a couple of things that we have to make sure. That is, one is make the unconstrained variables non-negative, and from here we have to select simplex. Simplex ELP, this is a linear program, which means that we are guaranteed to get the optimum solution, so we have to select that. And one more thing you need to check, this will not be a problem, but when you're using integer constraint, you have to make sure that ignore integer constraint is not checked, because if this is checked, that means solver will ignore all the integer constraint. You don't want that. Okay, so now solve and make sure that the solver has found a solution. So here it is, but see that the hires and fires are not integer. So let's go back in and add that range. Okay, select that range, and here to make it integer, all you have to do is to click this part and select INT, and that will make it integer. So now solve and make sure that you got the optimum solution. So now we have everything integer, and here is the autumn solution.